attention for the revision of chapter 1. Now for chapter 1, as the test has been conducted, so the answers I will discuss with you after checking tomorrow, all the answers, okay? And I will also recall all the questions, okay? So no need to discuss now. And now coming back to the revision of chapter 1. So, in chapter 1, that is letter to God, in this chapter, Lencho is a farmer who is living at the top of a hill, at the crest of a hill, and his house was alone in the valley, and where he was irrigating cornfield. Okay, he has grown cornfield, and he was quite expectant to get heavy rainfall so that his crops would flourish and he would ultimately get a rich harvest. Okay, so as the setting of the house, his wife was cooking food and the two young children, they were playing in front of the house while the elder two, they have gone to the fields to work. Yes, please. At the end, I will tell. And now, Lencho was quite observant in his nature. He was looking to the sky as the clouds gathered in the sky. He has come to know that soon these clouds will give a rainfall. Yes, of course, the rainfall started, a downpour started, but soon this downpour, it converted into storm of hails, right? So what he has compared those raindrops to? He has compared raindrops to pesos, the smaller ones to 5 pesos and the larger ones to 10 pesos. Okay, 10 pesos. Why he has compared? Because he knew that they were round in shape and that would ultimately fetch him some money. 5 paises and 10 paises, please check out. Cents? Okay, 5 cents and 10 cents? Right. Okay, then afterwards, when these raindrops, soon what happened, the north wind started blowing and these raindrops, they have converted into hailstorm. And when this hailstorm started to fall, he has compared the hailstones to that of silver coins. What he has compared them to? Silver coins. And it rained for almost 1 hour and later on the hailstones continue to fall for the next 1 hour. And ultimately what has happened, when he has paid a glance towards his fields, he has noticed that not even a single leaf was left on the plants. All the leaves have been withered out. All the flowers, they have been withered out also. And he has compared, the question was also there, what he has compared? He has compared the destruction caused by the hailstorm to that of plague of locusts. So what comment he has passed at that moment? What comment he has given? He has given the comment that whether or if the, you can say if the field would have been inflicted by plague of locusts, it would have left more than that of hailstones. So he was desperate, he was frustrated, and he was down in the dumps as all his cornfield has been destroyed. He thought that now what would happen? He thought that now next onwards he would not have anything to eat, and for the entire 1 year or for the entire next 1 year, his family will die of hunger as they don't have anything to eat. But at this very moment, his wife has given just a ray of hope, that is of God. What she said that God will never let anybody die of hunger. Throughout the night, Lencho kept on thinking that what will happen next, and ultimately what has happened? What has happened? He has come out an idea to write a letter to God. So finally what happened, as the day broke following Sunday, he went to the post office, took the letter, took the page as well as some ink and started writing a letter to God. And in his letter to God, what he has mentioned that his entire cornfield, it has been destroyed because of the hailstones and there is nothing left with him to eat. So he asked for 100 pesos. Okay, he asked for 100 pesos and ultimately he wanted to, so that he can grow some new crop and sustain the family throughout the year. So this letter, it reached to the postmaster. When he has read this letter, the address says to God, first of all, he broke into laughter. Why he broke into laughter? Because he did not ever in his life notice this kind of letter which was addressed to God. But on the second time, he felt the kind of belief that a person delivers in God. He has come to know that the person has staunch, firm, deep belief in God. Okay, so what happened next? So as he has got this kind of belief, he never wanted this kind of belief to be shaken apart. He wanted to answer this letter. So what kind of man a postmaster was? He was fat and amiable one, right? So as he has written this, ultimately, this letter, when it was opened, he has come to know that he is demanding for 100 pesos. And then he was not so affluent to give up all the money. So he has sacrificed a part of his salary. Moreover, he has also asked from his colleagues to give the money. And for that, what happened afterwards? He was not able to gather 100 pesos, but he was able to gather 70 pesos. And that was ultimately given to him. A letter was written back to Lancho and it was addressed as God. But why it was addressed as God? Why it was addressed as God? Because the postmaster did not want the belief to be shaken or torn apart, right? So finally, when Lancho was quite expectant to receive the letter, the postmaster did not hand him over the letter directly. But what he has done, he stood behind the window or behind the door in order to look over his feelings. Then ultimately, when he received the letter, he was very happy. But when he has opened the letter, he delivered the feelings with puckered brow. Puckered brow means folded with anger, or folded brow. Brow means forehead. So at that time, he felt that the money has been taken up by the post office employees, as he has asked for 100 pesos. And as he has asked for 100 pesos, but they have sent only 70 pesos. So he thought that the rest of the money, it has been taken up by the post office employees, and he has called him as bunch of crooks. So ultimately, what did the postmaster thought of him? What did the postmaster thought of him? That he was illiterate? No. He was greedy? But not grateful, but not thankful. Okay. So finally, this story, it delivers us the fact that sometimes when a person has not done anything, he has to get those kind of comments, like in that case of postmaster. Now coming up to the next part of today's revision is dust of snow. So what dust of snow is all about? Dust of snow. Give it afterwards. Dust of snow is about the importance of insignificant events in our life. Even the insignificant events or the very small events, they can also bring about great changes or great differences in our life. So here in this poem, the poet was sitting under the hemlock tree. Both hemlock tree and the crow, they are considered to be as negative, or you can say signs of ill omen, or negative signs of omen. But in this poem, the poet has broken that tradition and he has attached some positivity with that. Okay? So he has attached some positivity with that. So when the poet was sitting under the hemlock tree, then what happened? Some snowflakes, they have fallen onto the poet. And the day that has been dewed, he thought that the day has been dewed, finally it was revived back, because he came to know that something is left behind that can change his mood. And ultimately his mood, it has been changed from sadness to happiness, right? From sadness to happiness, his mood has changed. And this is how there are different themes. This poem is also related to the theme of positive or the healing effect of nature, healing touch of nature, that nature is always having healing touch and it delivers some positivity to us in one or the other way. Second is, you can say, significance of small events. And it is also showing a communication between nature as well as human beings. And what the message is being delivered by the poet? The poet has delivered the message that not all things are unimportant in life. Sometimes very insignificant things, very small things are also create great effects in our lives. Okay, so this is all about the revision of chapter 1 as well as poem 1. Eighth is, name a literary, this I'm going to discuss in the book only, right? Okay, actually, you are saying, it is alliteration. Yes, it is saved some, right? It will be right alliteration also. Alliteration and internal rhyme, both are correct. Okay, right? And another main literary device used here is enjambment. Okay, enjambment. Assonance, when there is, assonance means when there is repetition of sounds. If it is a repetition of consonant, vowel sounds, not at the starting of the word, but between, predominance is between the line, then it is assonance. Okay, and the same one is for consonants. Alliteration means between consecutive words, okay, in the starting letter. Okay, this is the difference. This is what I have just told now. Just told. Okay. Internal rhyme like in a paragraph. Okay, see in the paragraph, suppose there is crow, then me, then snow. Crow and snow is rhyming in a paragraph. In a paragraph when there is rhyming. Internal rhyme. Four. Right? So that's all for today. And in the next class, we are going to revise Nelson Mandela and Fire and Ice tomorrow. So that's all for today.